According to Rule 83.3, the delayed offside violation can be nullified under two conditions. All players of the offending team clear the zone at the same instant, permitting the attacking players to re-enter the attacking zone. As Marker intercepts the puck in the neutral zone, he then pushes the puck across the blue line with one hand, while Nichushkin is still in the Oilers zone.
Called in with other media members into the video room here at Ball Arena to see the reverse replay. And you can
see
Carr noticeably lifting his stick above the puck.
Okay, here we are. Noticeably lifting his stick above the puck. Like, it just happens to go off his stick. In a split second, he just happens. Like, how many people stick handle over? It's like, when has this rule ever existed? People saying he's not actually touching the puck then. This could have happened thousands of times this year, and a goal might have been scored, or a chance at least, but it was called offside. I've never even seen a play like, yeah, sure, I'm sure they might have missed one, but how many times did they actually miss one after viewing it on replay with challenges?
Boards, but waiting on the near side with it is Parento, trying to launch that up ice, and Duchesne takes it. He's in, he shoots, he scores! What a play! What a play! Now Nashville is screaming that this should not count. Like, does it, Peter?
Michael, it was so far offside, it's unbelievable. But the linesman, I believe, got screened. They're going to ask. I mean, when you see it, everybody in the building stopped.
Yeah.
Everybody stopped. Everybody, including Duchesne. I mean, this was, puck was just chipped up. You're going to see the puck comes down. I mean, the puck literally follows Duchesne into the zone. And here's another look at it. Now watch. You're going to see Duchesne. Mike, there's no way around it. It's just one of those. But Duchesne, give him credit. Everybody in the building, I mean, he knew he was offside. Yep. That's just one of those ones where the linesman, you know.
Neil McCarr noticeably lifting his stick above the puck, waiting for Nichushkin to exit the zone.
Waiting. Look at where his face is. He's looking not even in the right direction. He's looking away from Nichushkin. He never even see. Well, I'm sure he knew his notice him out of the corner of his eye, but there's no way he's noticing exactly where he is and waiting for him just to touch the puck.
However, according to the NHL's ruling on the goal, pushing the puck forward did not constitute an attempt at gaining possession. And he does not actually cross the blue line and take control of the puck in the offensive zone until Nichushkin has tagged up and come back onside. Once Nichushkin was deemed to have properly exited the zone, Marker gained sufficient control of the puck for it to be considered possession, making his zone entry an ensuing goal onside.
The Oilers don't like it, the fan base doesn't like it, but the NHL says it is the definition of the rule. Can I push back a bit? Just making a play here for common sense. Players don't always have the puck right on their stick when they're in possession of the puck. What actually constitutes having the puck? Because it was right there, and his stick was right there too.
McCarr knows the rule. So you're saying that he doesn't know the rule?
No, I think he knows
the rule. That's a real great joke.
For him to pull his stick up, let the player tag up, all in a split second, that's giving him a lot of credit.
What it do? It's your boy Dog Cherry, a.k.a. The Greater One. Gather round, class, because today our lesson is offside! Ever wonder why players stop in front of the blue line like it's an electric fence? It's because they don't want to go offside. The puck must enter the offensive zone before any of the offensive players. There's also something called delayed offside. If the offensive player doesn't control the puck while going offside, all they got to do is, you know what I'm saying, back out of the zone and start all over again.
It was determined that Colorado's Valane Nichushkin legally tagged up at the blue line before Cale Marker entered the offensive zone with the puck on his stick. Marker made contact with the puck in the offensive zone after Nichushkin was in an onside position, read an official explanation from the NHL.
Well, he can't just skate back in. If he does that without all of these guys coming back, it's going to be offsides again.
Maybe I can find some other examples of a delayed offside where a goal was called and see, like, where they actually let something like this go. Does anyone know a play like this? Because a lot of people are talking like, oh, yeah, that's the definition of the rule. Like, this kind of stuff, how many people have the puck exactly on their stick when they're crossing the line? Like, lots of people are stick handling or pushing it, and it's just off by it. It was off this stick by, like, 2 inches. Like, who cares about that? He's got control of the puck.
Cedric Paquette, required into the feet of Boyle. He has some room on the change, takes the shot, but an easy save for Price.
Now Boyle trying to center. Kokulis in front. Now over to help him out. Patterson had the puck taken away right in front. Kucherov shoots. He scores! 4
Like, there are a lot of variables here. Like, okay, if this is an official rule, bear with me, you know. If a guy had enough time and he saw, oh, his guy's coming back on, he's got to wait for them to tag up. All he has to do is, if he has enough room and time, he could, without having to wait now, even if the guy's way down in the zone, well, okay, not way down in the zone, but, like, he could push the puck over the line, you know what I mean? And the moment the guy crosses, now he could touch it and start stick-handling. He's already in the zone. What about this one, though? Can you do this? Here's another one. If you don't have possession of the puck on the line, it's good. So, like, what if you decided to just take a big slap shot at the goal? Like, you're not in a real scoring position from beyond the blue line, but you still can score. I mean, hey, the Calgary Flames can do it all the time on the Edmonton Oilers, apparently.
Well, I hope you learned much from this review. I'm a British person.